I was a kid, I had a rocking horse named Ranger. Out on the front porch, we would ride, we would ride. Little red cowboy boots, little red cowboy hat, and a pistol that shoots straight as an eagle flies.
I'm kind of pushing her buttons a little bit more than I did yesterday. Boy, you sure wouldn't want like a grouse to flush up out of the grass when you were riding her. Because that little thing right there kind of bothers her sort of a lot. I might want to use my flag a little bit when I go to the trailer, so she needs to be a little bit less scared of it than she is. Whoa. And go. And it's over there. So, Petra, you know, when I was talking to you the other day about the moving friendly game as opposed to the standing still friendly game?
Whole different deal.
She's a perfect example of she's, like, not okay with scary things when she's moving. And when the way she keeps kind of wanting to just sort of stop, that's what she thinks the answer to the question. She doesn't realize that it's just relax because it's not going to hurt you. She thinks if she just plants her feet in the ground that the scary thing will go away, and that's her answer to the question. There, that was a little change right there. Give her a little break. So if she's that kind of jumpy with the flag, you know, just because, you know, one of the lessons that your horse needs to understand is, like, when I have my energy up and I say go over that way, and if she doesn't do that, and then I stimulate with my flag or the tail of my rope, you know, that was my good deal, my suggestion, you know, and if she doesn't take it because either she doesn't feel like it or she didn't understand, then I come in with this to support. Okay, so this means move, because I'm saying go over there. You're not going. I really mean it. Go over there, right? But if I'm just here doing like this and the flag's like so, that doesn't mean anything. I'm not up. I'm not requesting. I have no intention other than to stand here and the flag is going like that, right? Okay, so where she's confused right now, which, you know, that's how they start. They don't know, you know, is she doesn't have the separation between, especially when she's moving, that when I'm asking her to move in the circle, if she's going where I want her to go at the speed that I want to go, then my leading hand, which is this one, the one that's closest to the halter knot, whereas this is my driving hand, all right? If my leading hand is kind of right out here in front of me, that's neutral. Even though she's moving, that means you're doing what I want. If I want her to go faster or go somewhere else, then I open that in, you know, kind of in front of me here. That's good. She's starting to pay attention, okay? And so when I'm... when it's in that position, and if this gets busy, then that's like you're supposed to be doing something other than what you're already doing. But if I'm in this position, she's doing what I want her to do. And if I'm doing this and whatever, that's just the dog running out from under the truck or like I said, the grouse coming out of the thing, or the Walmart bag in the wind, or it doesn't. She needs to not be concerned with that because I didn't tell her to do anything. Does that, see what I'm saying? So she just doesn't understand that separation yet. So she needs to practice by me stimulating, and she goes, ah, you know, I got to go faster. And then I'm going, I'm going to keep stimulating. Faster isn't getting you a release. Support her by putting some bumps on the lead rope to just kind of slow down and soften. And then when she does, go, oh, the flag stopped moving. And as a matter of fact, you can actually stop going in the circle and we'll just stand here for a second. So she gets a reward for finding the right speed and finding relaxation. Okay? So that's what I'm doing with her. And part of why I'm working with that today is because I may decide that I want to use this to help me with what we're doing at the trailer. And if right now, if I want to subtly use this to say, could you move your feet? And she goes, ah! It's not effective communication, right? I've pushed her into panic and then she's not thinking. So I need to have her have a little better understanding of how the flag works before I can use it in this application. And see what I'm gonna, so that's where I'm out there and it's like, well, what does that have to do with it? With this, well, she has to understand this a little bit better, or I won't be able to use it as a tool very effectively over there. Okay, so that's what we're doing.